Hello, Code & Solder is finally back with a new video. This time we'll look at another contender in the budget PCB market, JLCPCB, the manufacturer branch of EasyEDA. I tried to make this review a bit more concise while keeping all the relevant information. Please let me know what you think. This obviously is another sponsored video, though as always, all opinions are my own. First, let's talk about the most important factor when it comes to a low-scale PCB manufacturer, price. Right now, 10 simple 10x10 boards can be bought for as little as $2 for the first set and $5 for each subsequent one, plus the usual $10 for slow shipping or $25 for DHL. The price increases for anything more complex, though it stays really reasonable with a 4-layer board costing as little as $32. According to PCBShopper.com, they are currently the cheapest option shipped to USA for both 2 and 4-layer boards with all the default options. While all the usual laminate thicknesses cost the same, a big downside is that any solder mask color except for green costs a significant premium. One thing I really like here is the Gerber viewer, allowing me to quickly check if I uploaded the right files and reading the dimensions and layers from it into the calculator. The second one is automatic panelization, allowing ordering of multiple V-scored copies of one board for no extra cost. Here is how it looks in practice. While the maximum number of layers offered and extra features is smaller than a PCBWay I reviewed before, I doubt I will miss any of them, and the price and free panelization more than make up for it. As with many budget fabs, they charge a significant extra fee for multiple independent designs in the same file, making it usually not worthwhile. With the theory out of the way, let's talk about ordering and my experience. The ordering process is really simple. After adding all the boards to cart, you just check out like in any other online store. Within less than a day, I got an email confirming the files are correct. The boards were shipped around a day later and arrived in under 5 working days from when I ordered them. The boards came packaged just like the last time, a cardboard box with a DHL foil envelope with each set of boards individually bubble wrapped inside. Now let's verify the quality. Inspired by the comments under the previous review and technical problems with my scanner, I decided to try another photographic method. I will be using the setup I normally use for macro footage. Please let me know in the comments if you would like me to make a video about it. First, I printed out and photographed a square grid and overlaid the original on it. This has two functions. Firstly, enabling me to check if the camera is oriented vertically, and secondly, checking for distortions by verifying if the lines are straight. As both tests went okay, we can move on to the actual boards. After an unreasonably lengthy process of aligning them to the Gerber files, we can confirm what we already see from the pictures alone. The boards, while not perfect, are really decent. One important observation is that the solder mask lines separating the TSSOP14 pins are present, something cheap fabs often omit. On the other hand, they seem to overlap the pads, likely reducing their effectiveness. In practice, this was not a problem. All the drill holes are quite well centered on the pads, and the solder mask around them, while not perfect, doesn't significantly overlap them. Most likely the higher priced variants with smaller minimal feature sizes would look even better. I have found an example of BGA board made there on the EEV blog forums. While the text at this magnification looks quite poorly, and in my opinion is a bit worse than the one at PCBWay, it is still fully readable down to 0.8 mm, and with the right font probably even lower. So, let me list the conclusions while you look at the factory pictures they sent me. First of all, the competition in the PCB market is amazing. The prices are lower than ever, and with the manufacturer times they achieve, making boards at home is making less and less sense. Secondly, the boards I got are certainly good enough for me, and I really like working with PCBA. Plus they are the cheapest on the market, though it doesn't make a lot of difference for me personally. Thank you for watching, please leave any ideas and comments down below, and subscribe not to miss my future videos when they finally get made.